Gary Numan, Tommy Two-Tone, names of some pretty famous new wave groups. Good evening, everyone. I'm Bill Ratliff, and welcome to PM Magazine. Tonight, we're at Sound Warehouse on Greenville Avenue. If you were to come here and see their racks and racks of new wave albums, you would get a pretty good understanding how popular and how big new wave is. It's not just music anymore. It's America's newest subculture. You're going to find out about it in our very first story. In our second story, we'll meet author and master of terror, Stephen King. And we'll find out the fascinating story behind the spine-tingling movie, The Shining. Chef Tell will share his own special recipe for barbecue sauce. Dr. Jim Wasko has some advice on removing warts. And Joyce Kohewick looks at what's hot in sports equipment. You can have your own tennis court for $20. But now, let's take a look at New Wave. No, folks, it's not Halloween night, and this isn't a costume party. You're looking at part of America's newest subculture. These people are into the new wave scene.
Oh, it's just doing our own thing, you know? I mean, the 50s had Elvis Presley, the 60s had the Beatles, you know? 70s had, you know, Ted Nugent, whoever. Now the 80s, you know? Everything's got to change, and this is it.
New Wave is actually an enlarged version of the punk rock scene that began in England during the mid-1970s. However, these people aren't into the violence that so often accompanies punk rockers. They're just out to have a good time. And if that means dressing strangely and hopping crazily around the dance floor, well, to each his own. The core of New Wave is the music, which is basically simplified, fast-paced rock and roll. And a quick walk through just about any record store will show you whole sections of albums devoted to this new genre. Record sales, believe it or not, are pretty good.
People like it when it first comes out. They want the new things. But it takes some people a while to catch on. So after a first initial rush on albums, the business is kind of steady.
What's the matter with the crowd I'm seeing? Don't you know that they're out of touch? Well, should I try to be a straight student? If you are, then you think too much. Don't you know about the new fashion, honey? All you need are looks and a whole lot of money. It's the next phase, new wave, dance crazy. Anyways, it's still rock and roll to me. Everybody's talking about the new sound, funny, but it's still rock and roll to me.
And while the music may still just be rock and roll, New Wave is being marketed to the masses, and you can pick up their fashions at stores like Judy's in North Park. For instance, for the guy who likes to lie around in his vinyl jumpsuit, there's always this little number. Or for you ladies, do you remember pumps from the 50s? These black shoes, if you can see them in this bag, well, they're now available. How about this checked miniskirt? Do you like that? But to top off this outfit, you have to have this metal handbag. And oh yes, don't forget, in New Wave, plastic is very important. Scenes like this are increasingly common in the Dallas-Fort Worth area, and it's interesting to note a trend that started with anti-commercial ideals is now on the verge of selling out to support itself. Instead of continuing to laugh at the world of economic reality, many groups are trying to capitalize on the movement's growing popularity. They want recording contracts and high-paying club dates. In that respect, New Wave is following an old trend.
You know, we're living in such pressured times, and it's just a definite emotional release, the dancing that you've seen and stuff like that. It's a total release, and let's make a fool out of ourselves because we're so hip that we're square.
Like, New Wave is just a new expression of energy for people to, you know, enjoy. It's a new creative outlet. People enjoy to, you know, get energy from hearing it. to have the big bright lights, green, red, blue, and all that. Let's get away from having our hair out long and acting real doped out, and and it's more intellectual. It's just, you know, it's not let's boogie, let's get down. I guess it would be more like let's sit and really listen or really dance to something that we like, you know, and it's not forced on us by the radios.
There's an irreverent attitude about this new music. A sense of sarcastic humor is important to everybody involved. Groups like the Telefones do some funny songs about contemporary issues. Tunes like I'm Dying for Uranium. And their attitude reflects a growing sense of helplessness among today's youth about changing our world. It's an age-old feeling with a new twist. Hey folks, when you boil it down, New Wave has the trendy elements of modern American culture. New music, new clothes, and an attitude that isn't much different than new generations have had for years. It will be interesting to see where New Wave people are.